Let's now check in on the Philippine Stock Exchange's closing numbers, the local bourse. Let's take a look at that board. There you go, up by 1.5%, outperforming peers to bounce back above 6,200. We're also seeing value turnover up significantly to 35.1 billion pesos. We're going to see the breakdown later on, but first, let's discuss the PSE's performance this Tuesday. John Mangan joins us today on the Business Roadshow for our market analysis. John, hi, good afternoon.
Hi, Mamie. You're cutting into my nap time.
For a change, we're going to talk at the close.
So, thank you.
John, the PSE index outperforming today, up over 1.4%. Is this a head fake, or do you see something more substantial?
Substantial. We held 62. That was important. And I'm sorry, we held 6,000. That's important. Now we've broken above 62. And volume was good today. I'm looking at 63.50. That's the next. That's the next target. So yeah, this is optimistic.
Do you think it's sustainable?
Well, you can't tell if something's sustainable until it sustains. I mean, the stock market is like a love of being in love. Everything looks good at the beginning, but you have to take it on a day-to-day basis. I want to see follow through tomorrow. Now, the caveat on this market is it is the end of the third quarter. And all of the funds out there, they do not want to be holding issues that are at 52-week lows. And don't forget, it was only a few days ago, a week ago, that some of the biggest names on the Philippine stock market were trading at 52-week lows.
Something to watch out for. John, you mentioned how the third quarter is closing. There's still a lot of concerns and jitters. You know, rates will be higher for longer. And we're trying to figure out what that would mean. At a time when oil is up again, I mean, you've got Continental CEO saying it could hit 150 per barrel. I know you're also expecting oil to skyrocket again. And you've got Goldman Sachs, for example, saying that at least on Wall Street, they're looking at the biggest profits plunge since the pandemic in terms of what to expect from companies. Like, margins are going to get squeezed very tight. What are your expectations for the upcoming earnings season?
All right. I don't make expectations on earnings because nobody pays me for my predictions. I only make money from trading whatever's happening.
Do you trade based on earnings?
Oh, no, never, never. I trade because earnings don't propel the market. Buyers propel the market. I'm expecting oil to go to about 107. All right. That's not good for inflation here in the Philippines. And all this nonsense about what's happening in the U.S. with the shutdown. We shut down. The U.S. shuts down every year. It means nothing. Look, as far as earnings go, something I haven't written about it, but it's an important fact. Something's happening that has not happened before. Usually, when the U.S. economy goes into super high interest rates in comparison to where it was a year ago, you will see a squeeze on corporate profits, but it's not happening this time. The reason for that is all the corporations in the U.S. took advantage of the last 10 years borrowing money at very, very, very low interest rates. Now their excess cash is going into deposits and they are making a lot of money on their idle cash. And that's never happened before because interest rates were so low for so long. Is that going to squeeze profits? No, it's not going to at all. In terms of profit margins because of high oil prices, yes, there's going to be a problem with it. And the U.S. government is doing everything it can to keep oil prices as high as possible. I'm not going to go into the reasons why, but we all know.
John?
Well, no, because it has to do with the World Economics Forum Great Reset. All right. I mean, this idea that we're going to do without fossil fuels in 5 to 10 years is absolutely absurd. Yeah, we can do that, except their people are going to be starving and we're going to be doing real fine here in Southeast and East Asia. Yes, it's going to be tough in the U.S., but it's not going to ripple to the Philippines. The only thing that we have to be concerned about is not interest rates. We have to be concerned about high oil prices, and there is nothing that can be done about it because we are an oil import-dependent country, like Japan. We have problems here, but as far as the overall economic climate here in the Philippines, we are extremely stable, and that's going to be reflected in the stock market over the longer term.
Except for the oil in the equation, you're saying you're expecting oil to hit 107 per barrel. Is that the peak for you, John? You don't think 150 is happening?
Every time Goldman or Morgan or JP, all of those guys come out with oil predictions, you know it's because they're long oil. Yeah, they make a fortune if oil goes to 150. Back in 08 or whenever, Goldman was saying 250, and they were sitting on a ton of forward contracts. Oil will go, how can I say this? The oil producers have an obligation to charge absolutely as much as they can without diminishing demand. It used to be that they would look at the United States and say, how high can we go before the U.S. stops buying oil? The problem today is they don't care what the U.S. does. Why? Because all the oil they produce will be absorbed by China, Southeast Asia, India, like that. So they're not looking at the U.S. Nobody cares about the U.S. anymore. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. What they're looking at is like here in the Philippines, for example, which is as good an example as anything. How high can oil prices go before the Philippines is damaged enough to reduce demand significantly? I'm thinking anything over $100 is going to be the top. And of course, nobody knows what the price of oil is, because there is no oil market. The only guy that knows what the price of oil is the one that just bought a tanker in Dubai. And if you will notice what's happened in the past, there's one price for exporting to Europe, there's another price exporting to the US, and the Saudis discount oil that's exported to Asia. So we just have to see what happens. It's not gonna be beautiful, but it's not gonna be entirely gloomy over the longer term.
All right, John, shifting gears now, I wanted to get your take. What do you think is happening with Aboitiz Power? Aboitiz Power continues to buy back its shares. It's not exactly at its cheapest at this point. They continue to buy back shares even after the removal from the PSE index. I wonder if you've had a conversation with some of our fund managers. What has this done
to their portfolios? I don't talk to fund managers. Well, actually, they don't talk to me. Look, I told you a couple of 3 months ago that MPI delisting was not going to be a big deal for the market. Wholesome's going down, Aboitiz going down. I'll let you in on a little secret. I would not be a bit surprised to see first-gen delist also. That, in my opinion, look, I make my money trading the market. And with these companies delisting, what, the MPI people are going to suddenly sell their shares to MPI as they delist and take that money and go buy a condominium with it? No, they're going to go back into the market. And the same thing is going to happen with Aboitiz and any of the rest of the delist. Aboitiz is buying their shares back because they feel that that they'll probably, if they do delist, when they do delist, the shares will be more valuable in their account than they are today. So that's in my opinion, that's why they're buying back shares.
How much of a boost do you think is Bloomberry going to get now that it's replacing AP in the PSEI?
Oh my God, Bloom goes in, Bloom goes out, Bloom goes in. All right, they're like a jilted lover, for crying out loud. How many times have they been in and out of the index? I don't know, 2-3 times. Yeah, it's gonna go up a little bit because there are international funds that have to buy every stock on the index or proportionally buy into the index. It might go up a little bit. It might even go up a lot. I can't tell you that. But if it does start going up a lot, then I'll be buying it. No, because that's what I do. I buy issues that go up. But I can't tell you which ones are going to go up today.
Well, we're just going to have to wait and see. John, always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for the time. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, Mimi. See you. Bye.